Hello, my name is Walter, and this time I'm doing The Get Down. I really love this series. It's very musical, so that's why I'm doing the volume of the video very soft, but it's my audio is still strong. Anyway, I think it's very good. Like, it's very interesting. The only problem is, like, it's 50 minutes on average. Part two just released on April 7th, and I kind of just saw it today. So, anyway, I hope you guys enjoy it too, because I really love this series. Like, I really like the transformation and the thoughts and the struggle, because you know it's New York in 1977, during the disco era, and moving into the 80s, which was very much the pop generation. That'll be very interesting to see, because this is mixing hip hop and disco together, so it's very interesting to see what they're doing. And when hip hop and disco merged, it became R&B rhythm and beat. Without further ado, let's go. Yeah, this is a Netflix series, by the way. It's usually 50 minutes, but this one is about like 49, 58, which, you know, rounded up is 50 minutes. So this is I did get confused in the first episode, because like I was like, who is this? And then now I'm kind of getting it that this is the future. The future main antagonist, main protagonist, sorry. Yeah, this is the Bronx. Yep, part two is called 1978, by the way. And this is episode 7, by the way. Nice. Yeah, Ezekiel, sorry. He is our main protagonist. Nice. Nice, yeah. This is just corny, bro. You know, I'm kind of like I'm kind of interested, like how well this generation of Americans see, like the because like they showed the whole layout of New York, right? Like, is that like a pride thing? Like, 'cause I would really be proud, like seeing the new layout, but you know, also seeing the old layout and seeing that transformation come in. So it's very interesting. Just let me know in the comments below. I know the whole Twin Towers thing is like a little etchy, but I think it's still a showing of your past, you know? Like, no matter what, You'll always have that in your history books. Well, I mean, okay. Yeah, that's true. I mean, that's really beautiful if you really think about it. I think that graffiti is kind of like a destruction of private property, but I really think that instead of like jailing them, like they should really look at it and go, okay, like this is pretty good art. And so like they should instead like move them into like proper like street art, like you know, sanctioned street art. Like it's a tough debate. Like, is graffiti an art form? Of course, I say yes, but you know, it can't really say like we can't really say like it should be rampant, you know, as it was in 1970, 1970s New York, you know, and we have graffiti here in Malaysia as well, but it's very like it's quite rare, and you know some of it is sanctioned, so staying alive hey. I mean, Shushan. What? Nah, man. Hey. Hey. What is that, bro? Huh? Staying alive, staying alive. By the way, I never watched that Saturday Night Live, by the way. No, no, not the series. I watched a few of that, but the movie. Get down. Oh, nice. This is really good. Oh. Oh shit. Oh nice. I like that it's also like kind of like Motown in a way that they're doing it. Which is the 80s by the way, where it transformed there. Hey. What is this? I love the records as well, like that's something I'm like, yeah, that is fantastic, like holy shit, look at the design. That is pure 80s gold, man. Like for serious. Totally tubular, man. That nigga's name is Switchblade. Disco. Oh. the village people. I've heard about them, but never seen them. I see what you did, son. Wind and fire. Yeah, this is one of the ones that went into the transition of the 80s as well. Yeah. Remember? September. Agent and representative. Yeah. Hey! That's some Charlie's Angel shit, man. Nice. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Hey, fuck it, knife. Yep, it's coke. Try hard. 2 minutes. Yep. No pressure. okay. Well, I mean, you know, that was pretty fast. I mean, you know, you still gotta pander, you know, you still gotta get a shout out to your sponsors, your people who gave, and if the people who gave you something back, you know, it's a two-way street. Yeah. I mean, what? That was long. Nice. Bro, chill. Oh. Oh. I mean, you know. Yay. I mean, that's true. That is true. Hey. You got a pander, man. That's show business. That's business for you. That's not only show business, that is business for you. Like business in general. This is very simplistic melodies. It goes up, up, down, down, up, down, down. But it's catchy. And that's music in general, you know? You tried, bro. You tried. Nice. Her voice is really good. Like, that's one thing I'm like, yeah, that was really good though. Nice. Nope. I have a strange feeling she'll say no. Yep. Called it. Oh, you can't do Nephilim. That's very weird, you think I'm weird. I mean, that's true. That shit was deep. I get it. I get it. I mean, okay. I need to. I mean, you know. I mean, you know, it's like, it's hard for someone like this. Like, this kind of star to be controlled. Like, it's controlled by your parents, family, and then also the agent and everything. Oh, I love these, I love these transitions into like the comic pressed animations, and his comic skills are pretty good. Like I think he has a chance of being like a comic writer. And that's the thing with like with graffiti artists, like they're really good with their art. Like I think they can become proper artists, and that's why I say don't throw them into jail. This is weird though, I mean, yeah. That's cool, bro. Yeah, that's true. I mean, Dr. Seuss is probably. I mean, that's also true, you know? Hey. Oh yeah, Saturday Night Fever, sorry. Oh, iced, bro. I mean, that's true. Dun, 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 dun. Money, money, money. Money, 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 money. I feel like Shaol is kind of like getting separate from the group, like he's becoming more isolated, and like you can definitely see strains to the group's dynamics. Great alert video. I mean, that's also true. Yeah, this is I'm reflecting on like I forgot it. I'm reflecting towards La La Land now, because like that's also kind of like the relationship being pushed apart. I think they're gonna break up though. And it's really hard, you know, when certain parties, you know, can, you know, compromise. And if I mean, you know. I mean, there's a lot of things that come into play when you're having a relationship, and you also have other factors coming in. Another, I'm gonna get you. Why you do that? But yeah, as I was saying, like, I'm sorry, sometimes the series just pulls me in and I can't remember what I was thinking about. Is that there's always gonna be factors which pull you away from your dreams, and also sometimes the opposite way as well, like pull you away from your relationships, and that's all it is. You'll hear it. Oh, I get it. Agua. Water, right? fuck. I mean, yeah. Rome wasn't built in a day, son. Yeah, shall. Shall. It repeats itself, yeah. You can dance to it, bro. I mean, you know. Bruno Mars. Up, bro. Hey, the reflections, dumb reflections, son. It's a lot of like noise and confusion. Yeah, I get it. It's the yeah, that's not suspicious at all. At all. Sorry. I mean, you know. Yeah, that's true. Oh, that I thought, what was that? I because it looked like wires, you know? Honesty. That's true. I mean, you know, a little honesty there. Nice. That was a good way to end it though. Like I really liked the structure and everything. So that was really good. Like that was a really good episode. Especially like the ending. The endings are always like really good way to come together and just close it out. So yeah, that was about it. And you know, if you want me to do more of this or you know anything else, just comment below and subscribe. My physics is bad. Anyway, see you guys at Samurai Jack. See you then.